You're welcome. We'll go to our newspapers now, and like usual, we start with ABS website, www.absradiotv.com. That's how we look at several other papers. And joining us this morning to look at these issues and more is Comrade Kana Ayobidibo. Comrade Kana Ayobidibo is a public affairs analyst. Welcome to Good Morning Anambra this morning.
Thank you for having me.
Yes, we begin with ABS website. Anambra Widows Summit ends in Awka with call for end to obnoxious practices against vulnerable persons. Mrs. Obiano tasks women to protect husbands, children against political thuggery. ABS to receive another award for media excellence. IVM Newe reassures on increased service delivery capacity building programs as Obiano National Defense College Abuja visits company. Those are the stories on the site of ABS website. If you want to get the stories and the details, you can go to the site. But for now, we'll look at the issues being raised there.
Yes, and let's first of all look at the widows, the just concluded summit. Mr. Anayo.
Yeah, I think it is a welcome development in our climate for us to show some sensitivity towards the widows that actually have lost their husband. In most cases, the husbands are the breadwinners. And for this government to have a summit in which they will be given some kind of sense of belonging and actually to let them know that even though their husband has been taken away from them by death or whatever, but they are still loved by the people of Anambra State, and if a program is actually designed to accommodate these widows, not a situation where bags of rice are being shared to them or some detergent, but the situation where these widows are being empowered so that they'll be able to cater for their family.
Okay, but what actually that was looked at yesterday was the obnoxious practices that are being meted on women at the death of their husbands.
That's what I'm saying.
Whereby some of them will be asked to scrape their hair, some do it with broken bottle.
You see,
they will be asked to sit in, you know,
you see,
horrible things that hit at you. You don't see people, I mean, that being happened to widowers.
That's why this summit is a good one. To be able to educate the women that they have a right as human beings, not to be treated like they didn't kill their husband in most cases. And as such, the culture should not subject women to such barbaric act, situation where you want to shave a woman that lost the husband with a broken bottle,
the water that is used to
wash the cup, and then.
But it seems that at some point, even some of these widows who might have passed through this obnoxious practice before, at times are the people that had heard of seeing that other people that encounter such situation also pass through that same thing they passed.
That's wickedness. So the men should stop
them.
Also a role to play.
That women should have a role, but I think the men should take a lead, because in any group of people where people are in a communal setting, there should be law and order. The men should actually, call the shot. A situation where you should allow women to persecute other women because their husband died, or maybe probably they have gone through. It's like when you are in the school, and then you pass through class one, and you were bullied, and when
it is your turn,
you want to really bully.
That's why I say, let's move ahead. In line with that, the governor's wife also called on women to protect their husbands and their children from political thuggery. That is. Here with us now, okay?
Yeah, it's good because women by their nature, they are peaceful people. And a situation where they'll be able to talk to their husband, talk to their children, please don't engage yourself into political thuggery And then I think they actually have a role to play as mothers at home.
And Anyagwapalo, no?
Anyagwapalo, that's very important.
Okay, just recently, ABS received Award of Excellence, and then another one is on the pipeline now. What do you think is going on?
Well, I think the ABS has actually come of age in media activities or the media industry. And if they are judged to be given an award based on performance by some organization, I think it is good, and I am happy to associate with ABS.
Thank you very much.
So now we'll go over to the Daily Sun. On the front page of the Daily Sun newspaper, we have 2019, no support for Buhari, article UK. British government vows to remain neutral. Beside the nameplate there, Anambra set to stop Osuka's system December 28. I didn't say I will probe Fayose, that's from Fayemi. Party primaries, President Faults Oshomole says aggrieved APC members can go to court. UI International School reopens, bars parents, journalists. President approves salary increase for police. Those are the stories on the front page of the Daily Sun. 2019, no support for Buhari, article, UK. Are you taking those promises to the bank?
Well, I wouldn't do that because these are it's diplomatic statement. We wouldn't. They want to remain neutral. But the undercurrent is being blown by these foreign hands in Nigerian politics. Most of the time, they actually entertain our leaders that go to Chatham House to say one thing or the other, and those are political statements they go there to
and
make.
And where do you think the wind is taking them this time around? We have northern candidates, Buhari from the northwest, and then Atiku from the northeast. So where do you think?
Well, I think for the first time we're having a formidable and credible opposition. As the election is drawing nearer, so everybody is like looking
at what I'm saying. If the UK is to support, what do you think they will support among between these two?
Since they say they wouldn't come out to support,
let's give it to them.
Open,
let's give it to them.
I can tell you,
Okay. Then our second story here says, Anambra set to stop Osuka's December 28th. That's even a date.
Wow, that would be a wonderful kind of jamboree, trying to set a standard that no one is an outcast. Mm. That is what is.
But do we still have something like that around here in Anambra?
Of course we do. We sure have, but it's not something that is within the communal setting where. They have those segregations. They say, we don't want to deal with this man because we don't know the paternity. We don't know how he come about being in one home or the other. So I think at the owner level here in Anambra State,
there's still a possibility of such existing.
Yes.
Before we move to the next paper, party primaries, President Faults Oshomole says aggrieved APC members can go to court. You remember the APC national chair said that if you go to court, you are against the party and might receive some sanctions. But the president is saying that anybody that is aggrieved has the right to go to court.
But the point remains that in political party administration, there are organs of a party that deal with the dispute resolutions and all that. Mm. So, and the last resort is always the court actions. And I think what they are trying to say is let us exhaust what we have within the organs of the party that we have set up to look into all these grievances. And
we're saying that the party chairman,
of course, they have set up. They set
and
up like
the president is supporting him now.
Arebesola is one of the members of those committee that are looking into.
But in a case where an aggrieved member is not satisfied with the composition of that reconciliatory committee, he wouldn't even want to go there to sit down.
Yeah,
I think reconciliation is reconciliation committee are usually let me say an alternative instead of going to court.
But the point remains that in our climb they say the party is supreme. You could be suspended, and once you are suspended and you are no longer a member of that party, you don't hold them culpable in any issues you are taking to court.
The president and the chairman in a discordant tones. Are you suspecting a divided house?
Well, I think Oshimole is the chairman of the party.
What? The president said no. But I don't agree with him.
I don't see where a situation where Donald Trump is trying to tell the Republicans what to do in their party.
That's America.
No. That's what we are copying presidential system.
Okay. All right. Let's move over to the next paper, Daily Times. On the Daily Times this morning, judge to social media bloggers, spread wrong news, go to jail. That's a strong one. Warns bloggers against contempt over wrong interpretation of court proceedings. Says court's hallowed chamber forbids opinion before final judgment. Buhari counters Ochemole insists aggrieved members can go to court. CJ reassigns EFCC suit from Justice Inyako to Justice Ojukwu. Federal government confirms 1,640 suspected cases of yellow fever. Polio, northern states sign MOU to strengthen routine immunization. And beside it, nameplate that we have, imbibe fiscal discipline, cut overhead costs, federal government tells states, pledges to ensure all federation revenues are accounted for in transparent manner.
Actually, so they're talking about the minimum wage, because that was why they were asking the state governments to cut costs. Okay, let's move ahead.
Okay. So looking at the stories there, a judge is concerned about the activities of social media bloggers when it comes to issues still pending in the court. Do you think this is a step in the right direction or a way to curb or to stop people from expressing their freedom of expression?
Yeah, you see, freedom of expression is allowed by our constitutional provisions. But there are a situation where false information are being dished out to the general public, you will know the effects. Like we said, the news is the widest traveler, is the fastest traveler. And then with the social media introduction into our news dissemination, you find out that before you know it, just like the old saying, the bad news gets everywhere. And it is a way of trying to caution, those who are on, technology has actually done a lot in a way of this bad news or, bloggers trying to, people like they that wants to do havoc, they don't want to be noticed. So if there is a law, that's a law that says if you do that, you go to jail, it will help to regulate the system.
All right, it will help to regulate the system. We'll move over to the Punch newspaper now. The Punch is filled with stories, so we'll take as much as we can this morning. Buhari falls, Oshomole says aggrieved members can sue APC. Still the story from making the headlines in most of the papers. We'll miss 2019 target for refineries revamp, Kachipu. Yellow fever hit 7 states, 1,640 cases reported coming from the federal government. Nongi decries Buhari, EFCC silence on local government funds diversion. PDP urges NAS to investigate killing of soldiers. Those are the major stories on the front page of the Punch. If you want to get more details, you can go to the paper, pick a copy and get more stories there. Let's look at Nongi decries Buhari EFCC's silence on local government funds diversion.
The issue of local government not enjoying autonomy, and most chief executives from different states are actually holding to that fund and then doing whatever they like with it without checks and balances. And the EFCC actually should have been able to look into financial, because that's why they created, the act that created them empowered them to look into the finances of most states, government functionaries, parastatals, so that they'll be able to, to control. Well, a situation where funds are being diverted and nobody is talking about it, that's why we
do you think is a constitutional or legal loophole that has instituted this level of diversion without measurable punishment or sanctions given to the state governments involved?
You see, the idea remains that the constitution actually empowers, because we have 3 tiers of government. Mm-hmm. So the local government should have their direct allocation from the fiduciary account as their own appropriation for them to be able to function at the grassroots level, because this is why the local government system is actually introduced in this country. Okay. We used to have the councillors, but now the funds are being diverted by most chief executive because the authority involved, you know, keeps a blind eye while all these things are being done in the states.
Okay, let's move ahead. PDP urges stars to investigate killing of soldiers.
Yes,
and we all know what really happened.
It's a terrible situation.
It's horrible.
It's a terrible situation.
How could that be?
That Boko Haram, call them ISIS, call them Al Qaeda, call them anything, what they are affiliated to, and now actually attacking the military installations are no more soft targets. Mm. And we have equipment, we have men. A situation where the commander and the brother of his died in the same attack.
It's horrible. Yeah, yes, but they say they don't have sophisticated equipment to challenge.
Are they ready? The point is that they
could let's really get to the bottom of this. Yes. Because I know recently that Buhari ordered for the, first of all, ordered for forgiveness, amnesty, and then recruitment of Boko Haram, captured Boko Haram members back to the military.
You see the point.
And now we are having this.
He summoned the service chiefs on a Sunday.
We have not heard anything.
Okay, he summoned the service chiefs on a meeting on a Monday on this issue, and it is becoming one killing too much. Like, for instance, the same route in Borno State, where they are coming from, is a route that they want to maintain and they don't want military installation. That's their attacking route.
All right, let's take the remaining papers. Maybe we'll still encounter a story that touches on that. The Nation newspaper now, APC members free to seek legal redress, says Buhari. Change of guards in Oshun as Oyetola takes over today. INEC witness to tribunal, a kitty pool free. Fur, Ten feared killed in court clash. Federal government AFDB to establish $500 million fund for ICT. Mikel opens football clinic. Better pay, pension coming for police. Those are the front page at the front page of the Nation newspaper. We'll also take the Guardian together now. Buhari cautions Oshomole, okay suit by APC members. Buhari ignored intelligence on Boko Haram killings, South African firm alleges. I think this is related to what we were saying. Anambra government backed December 28 deadline to end Osuka's system. EFCC rejects Ganduje's 10 million donation. 10 million naira donation. As Nigeria struggles with 30,000 naira, South Africa increases wage to 126,000. 480 naira. That's minimum wage in South Africa now.
And we are battling with
30,000 naira.
Okay, this Buhari ignored intelligence on Borno killings, South African firm alleges, which means there was signal, there was intelligence report that something is about to happen, and nothing. Nobody did anything.
You see, people have been crying out that their service chiefs have actually outlived their usefulness as the as the service chiefs of various divisions in this country. A situation where Boko Haram attacked a military base and no information went out, the Air Force personnel were not ready to go for a sortie along the line, and there was no synergy between the Air Force and the military. So for them to be able to have a counter attack, and these people will come in, the sergeant will come in, do whatever they want to do, take whatever they want to take, kill those who they want to kill, and then they go back.
Even go with abducted some of the people that they killed.
Yes, oh yes.
I know the funny thing about this story is that a timeline report by a major online newspaper said that the same time this killing occurred was the same time that service chiefs were in the presidency while the presidency was releasing the next level campaign manifesto. Attending APC.
Just look at that.
It's a painful one for
our
country.
Very painful.
The security chiefs, the commander in chief, should do something now to ensure that we put ourselves back in order, both for the safety of Nigerians and in the face of the international community. This is where we'll be calling it a wraps for newspaper headlines for this morning. We were joined by Comrade Kana Ayobidibo, expressing his views and opening up some issues as concerned this stories on the front pages of the newspaper. And IJ is here with me as we looked at the papers.
Okay. Remember, thank you very much for joining us.